Lord be with you. A reading of the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to Matthew. At that time, Jesus said, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink. Or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds. Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap, nor gather in barns. And yet, your heavenly Father feeds them. And not you hold of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying about clothing, consider the lilies of the field, how they grow, and they neither toil nor spin? Yet, I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ, O Lord.
On behalf of the family, they give you certain words.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. I am very, very grateful to be here. And I know my brothers and sisters are very grateful to be here, as well as my family, my cousin Joe, as well as my little granddaughter. And a very special thanks to that Friday to come and visit us as well. And all of our cousins and all the guests, thank you all so much for coming. Today is a very, very special day. Not many people celebrate these meetings. I am truly grateful of one of my children, young, wanted to last, the younger sister's dead. I mean, it's going to be a little, toy that I will try to get everything together. Standing in front of y'all is kind of cool, but also a little nervous as well. But I just want to thank everyone, brothers and sisters. My mom has trained us all very well. My mom is an icon and a legend. And to look at her and to spend time with her, it's amazing. She has taught us all the best lessons that life could have taught any kid on this earth. God bless my mom. God bless my mom to see 100 days from today. I went to home last night and said, "Lord, when the clock struck 12, I know my mom did that all." Say my prayer. Very grateful to stand as a son and to stand boldly and bravely with my faith, my heart as a man. Mom, thank you very kindly for your untiring task as a lady. It was very hard. My dad, a great man, went out to see work, and he worked very hard for us as well. And I remember the day when I came here, I stand up. That was my father passed away about 40 years ago and months. I think to myself, will I ever get an opportunity to speak again on this place? I did, and I'm very grateful. Thanks to the Reverend, thanks to all. A very unique story. I remember most of all with mommy's when I one day, you know, Christmas Eve day, she went to St. Vincent, and I was there with my dad, and in suffrage was coming. And it's a cool story, the best story, the one that I will never forget. And he looked at me, he said, David, French Bros is coming with a ball in his mouth, daddy coming. And I took her for speed to meet her because, you know, Christmas Eve day, she bring us goodies. I want to help her with a box. But, you know, the funny part about him, there was a place out of the house, Larry Wallace, he surrounded it. And she said, what would you like to drink? And as a young lad, it's Christmas time, and I felt very festive. I said, give me a cold Guinness. And she gave me the Guinness, I drank the Guinness. So when I drank the Guinness, it was hot, so I think the Guinness kind of tripped up a little bit. And she looked for me, and she reached out for Papamitri Bridge. So she didn't see me come with the box. And she looked back, she said, oh man, she came back to me. So she said, how come you didn't come? And I said, man, the Guinness. So I sat down until I feel good and then I took the box. So I had a very, very beautiful, memorable time with my mom. And to tell you the truth, I got ashamed of it. I was more, it was the previous one. I always make my little sister trouble because these days we are kind and still, and we are both a little too old. We drink all the other milk. And then she said, who drank that milk? And I said, oh, we're drinking. So she didn't beat both of us. But I just feel so devious and in trouble. So these are some of the things I remember very well. You know, we grew very loving as a family. I cannot be more grateful, you know, to my family. And really and truly, it is a milestone. When I see mom sitting there at 100, I said to myself, by that good jeans, I better ask her for some good bush. So maybe I could make it too. But if I could make it, I could need someone in the family to make it. You know, it is really nice to have a mother like my mom, a great lady. She loves cooking very well. And many times I will put it in the harbor, people meet me and say, you know, that little old lady is your mother? And I used to be so, yes, yes, that's my mom. And so, well, she always plays a football with us, and she likes to play cricket. So my mom really made a legacy amongst the people, a very, very good lady. We thank you so much for coming. We all will have a beautiful day. But above all, the fact that we can thank today, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for God. For God, I made it possible for my mom to see 100th birthday. And I know that He Himself will give us our long life. May God bless us all. May y'all live a life that is God fearing. This is the end. And truly, without a shadow of a doubt, Jesus will come again. Don't forget that. So don't let any issue or any problems or anything deter you from doing good. Do good. For this life that we live is only a passing life. But the real life is yet to come in Christ Jesus, our Lord. God bless you all, man. God bless you. God bless you, mom. And thank you for all you have done for us. Have a beautiful day. And I pray that God will give you many more years. What a beauty that will be. Thank you so much, everyone. And God bless you.
He also created man. And man fell away because man was disobedient. And so we seem to have lost contact with the God who made us, who loved us, who nurtured us, and who brought us to this place. I am not going to give you, as it were, an optimal sermon this morning, but I want to share with you, this is one of the main points. She once told me a silly story. I think it was about a play video. When she was playing some cricket against the men, and there was five tennis. This didn't seem to be able to handle the men. She was skipping through the water, and whatever the skipper said, I don't know. But she came in, she delivered, and the stumps flew. That was something that she said to Greg Stephen. Do you remember Father Greg? Your boyfriend? To Father Stevens and myself. And after the stumps flew, pandemonium took over the game. Because she had bowled. So I think that is representative of the area. Who felt he was a cricketer? Madam. I remember one day when I had come to beg my husband. Bunyan was a person who I have always admired. Nothing she had was too much to share. Nobody she met was below her feeling, and she shared that love of God with everyone who gave it to her. I have been coming back to Lake for quite a while, and you know, I come in Saturday on Saturday night, Sunday morning, the two masses, and I'm on the road at 4 o'clock going home. So I have not seen her in quite a long time. My mom, go ahead. God bless you with 100 years. I hope He'll give you some more. Thank you. I don't
Britannia that if you make one God, it can be greater. Greater. Greater than never. Never. He said, no other land.
Thank you. Bunyan hymn 586.
Oh,
Processional Hymn 375.